Hi, good morning. In this video we'll discuss about industrial drives and applications in module 3, in that operation with unbalanced source voltage and single phasing. So this is a very important topic. The questions will come from this topic. Explain the operation with unbalanced source voltage and single phasing. But this topic is very easy if you know, if you understand the logic. So first we will see the why unbalanced source voltages will occur. Sometimes due to fault, symmetrical fault, unsymmetrical faults, maybe unbalanced voltages will occur, right? The supply voltage may be increase or decrease. For three phase circuit, what is the supply voltage? 440 volts 50 hertz. It may reduce to 400 or 380, it may increase to 440 above also. So due to that, unbalanced source voltages occurs in induction motor drives. So we'll see one by one how we are going to solve this one. What are the speed torque characteristics when unbalanced source voltages occurs, right? As supply voltage may sometimes becomes unbalanced, it is useful to know the effect of unbalanced voltages on motor performance. So I told you, right, the torque and speed may be varies due to unbalanced source voltages, right? So here a three phase set of unbalanced voltages we are considering as a VA, VB and VC can be resolved into three phase balanced positive sequence and negative sequence and zero sequence voltages. Using symmetrical component relations, what is VP, what is VN, what is V naught? So using symmetrical components, VP you can write it as a 1 by 3 VA plus alpha VB plus alpha square VC, and a negative sequence VN is equal to 1 by 3 VA plus alpha square VB plus alpha into VC will come here. And zero sequence V naught is equal to 1 by 3 VA plus VB plus VC, where alpha is equal to e power j 120 degrees. That is, that you can write it as cos 120 plus j sin 120, right? Positive sequence voltages have the same phase sequence as original system, but negative sequence voltages are opposite phase sequence, right? It will be assumed here the machine does not have neutral connection, that is delta connection. Delta connection we don't have neutral, and star connection we will have neutral, right? In delta connection, neutral is absence, right? So in the absence of neutral connection, zero sequence line voltage become a zero. So zero neutral is not mean, neutral is not, then neutral voltage will be zero. Positive sequence voltages produces air gap flex wave, which rotates at synchronous speed in forward direction. Positive sequence means the sequence will be in RYB, right? So the rotation will be in forward direction. And negative sequence means any phase, any two phases in three phase supply may be interchanged. That's what will happen. The rotation of the induction motor will changes. So in positive sequence it is rotated in forward direction. In negative sequence what will happen? It is rotated in negative, that is reverse direction, right? So here in forward rotor speed omega m and slip is s, right? So here positive sequence voltages equal to equivalent circuit are same as shown in figure 1. Earlier video we have seen this one. Sequence supply voltage V, right? So here what we are doing, in place of V we are replacing with VP. Here we are replacing with VP just. So here what will be the rotor current, what will be the torque in positive sequence, right? So rotor current IRP dash is equal to VP by RS plus RR dash by S plus J into XS plus XR dash. That is the rotor current in positive sequence, and torque Tp is equal to 3 by omega ms into Vp square Rr dash by S whole divided by Rs plus Rr dash by S whole square plus Xs plus Xr dash whole square. So that is the torque in positive sequence. So coming to the negative sequence, voltages produces air gap flux wave which rotates at synchronous speed in reverse direction, right? So the slip is equal to minus omega ms minus omega n by minus omega ms. Here we are denoting with s n. In positive sequence, what we denoted s. So here s n is the negative sequence slip. So substituting in equation 3, finally you will get s n is equal to 2 minus s, right? So now what we are going to do is, so in figure 1 already we have calculated rotor current and torque. So in place of so supply voltage V, so we are replacing Vn, right? So just from equation, in equation 1 we are replacing V in place of Vn. So by that we will get rotor current and torque equations. So in negative sequence, the rotor current I dash Rn is equal to Vn by Rs plus Rr dash by 2 minus S. Here in place of S, what is the slip is here negative sequence 2 minus S. You have to substitute that one, plus J into Xs plus Xr dash. Coming to the torque, Tn is equal to minus 3 by omega ms into Vn square Rr dash by 2 minus S divided by Rs plus Rr dash divided by 2 minus S plus Xs plus Xr dash whole square. So this is the negative sequence torque, right? So now what is the total torque in induction motor? So we need to add positive sequence torque and negative sequence torque, similarly rotor currents also. So here rotor current Rr dash is equal to this is in RMS value I dash Rp square plus I dash Rn square whole power 1 by 2. So this is the rotor current. Next one, torque is equal to Tp plus Tn, that is a positive sequence torque plus negative sequence torque. So those equations substitute here. So suppose Vp positive sequence supply voltage and negative sequence supply voltage both are equal, then the total torque on induction motor is equal to 0. This is very, very important. So we will observe this condition in graph. So speed, torque, statics graphs we have. So there we will observe this torque is equal to 0 when Vp is equal to Vn, right? So in case torque is equal to 0, we'll see in this below graph. See, positive sequence, negative sequence are positive sequence, negative sequence, and the resultant speed torque characteristics as shown in the below figure. So unbalanced stator voltages when positive sequence and negative sequence it is equal to equal, here equal, torque is equal to 0, then already speed is equal to also 0. So this side negative sequence will produce negative torque, positive sequence will produce the positive torque as is here. So this is the negative sequence speed torque characteristics, and this is the positive sequence speed torque characteristics. So this is the resultant characteristics, net characteristics of the induction motor. So when stator is having unbalanced voltages, stator is having unbalanced voltages, this is the speed NT, speed torque, that is we can simplification, and we'll call it as a NT characteristics. So in single phasing also, suppose So the motor is running in single phasing, same type of characteristics will appear because voltages will be unbalanced, right? So already we have seen when Vp is equal to Vn at zero speed and S is equal to Sn, consequently torque is equal to zero. So this is about speed torque characteristics. So interaction we will see. So interaction between positive sequence and air gap flux wave and positive sequence rotor currents produce positive sequence torque. Already we have seen in the graph. So positive sequence will produce positive torque. And similarly, negative sequence torque Tn is produced due to interaction between negative sequence flux and negative sequence rotor currents. So due to that, will produce the negative sequence torque. That is, torque will be in a negative direction. So here, when due to these pulses, pulsating torques, negative sequence and positive sequence torques. So here, see this one. So due to this positive torque, this is negative sequence torque, negative torque, and this net torques. So what will happen? The total, the resultant torque inside three phase induction motor is unbalanced. That is pulsating. Pulsating due to pulsating torque in induction motor, what will happen? The motor will vibrate. So motor will vibrate and what will happen? The losses will increase and efficiency will also reduce. So finally, the life of the motor, the life of motor, and produce harm. So here the reduce the life of the motor and produce the hum, that is frictions, noise and vibrations will occur, right? Hum means vibrations or frictions or noise. So this is the produces hum in induction motor, right? So thank you. Please watch this video and comment your comments. We'll also see that we'll update and more information in upcoming videos. Thank you once again, right?